Hello students, in this video let us start solutions topic. So what are the solutions and what are the different type of topics present in this lesson, let us see here. So first come to the solution. Solution means what here? A homogeneous mixture of two or more than two components is known as a solution. A homogeneous mixture of two or more than two components is known as which one? Solution. So that homogeneous means what here? That appears like a single phase. We can't identify the two different or more than two different components present in that. So the total solution will appear as a single phase. So like that, the type of homogeneous mixture of two or more than two components is known as a solution. Okay, now here, what are the types of solutions and what are the terms present in solution? Let us see here. So, for example, if any two chemical substances are mixed to get a homogeneous solution, it is said to be binary solution, because two different substances, two chemical substances, as two substances are present, it is said to be binary solution. So that means what here? Binary solution contains which one? Two different type of chemical substances. Like that, if three chemical substances are present in a solution, it is known as a ternary. If four chemical substances are present in a solution, it is known as a quaternary. So like that, based on the number of chemical substances present in a solution, they are classified as binary, ternary and quaternary solutions. Okay, then how we have to prepare the solution and what are the terms present in solution? Let us see here. So the first, a solution contains two important terms here. First one is solute and second one is solvent. Solute and solvent. Solute means what? The substance which is present in less quantity, that is said to be solute. Which is in less amount, that is said to be solute. Or which is to be dissolved, that is also called solute. Then come to solvent. What is the meaning? The substance which is in excess amount, that is said to be solvent. Or in which solute is dissolving, that is known as solvent. So which is to be dissolved is solute. In which we are dissolving solute is known as solvent. So one example, if you want to prepare salt solution, what we do? Salt should be dissolved in water. That means here, salt is to be dissolved and in water that is dissolved. That means here, salt is said to be solute, water is said to be solvent. So like that here, we can define which one? Solute and solvent. Okay, then after that, types of solutions. So different type of solutions are there. In that, so many classifications are there. Based on the nature of the solvent, one type of classification. Based on the physical state of solute and solvent, another type of classification. Based on the amount of solute present in a relative amount of solvent or a particular amount of solvent is another type of classification. So like that, solutions are classified into different types. For example, if you consider classification of solutions based on nature of solvent. So what are the types here? If solvent is water, that type of solutions are called aqueous solutions. And if solvent is other than water, that solution is known as non-aqueous solution. If solvent is water, what is the name? Aqueous solution. If other than water, if any other solvent is there, they are said to be which one here? Non-aqueous solutions. So you have to remember, in the any problem they have given, aqueous solution means solvent is nothing but which one means water. So we have to remember that point. If solvent is alcohol, those are called alkosols. And if solvent is benzene, that solution is called benzosol. Like that, other than water means they are called non-aqueous solutions. So this is one type of classification based on that nature of the solvent. Then the second type of classification, this is based on physical states of solute and solvents. So now here the first point you have to remember, based on physical state of solvent only, three type of solutions are present. How many types? Three types of solutions based on physical state of solvent only. So what are the three types here? The first one is solid solutions, and the second one is liquid solutions, and the third one is gaseous solutions. So based on the physical state of solvent only, three type of solutions are present. These are the three types. What are here? These are solid solutions, liquid solutions, gaseous solutions. That means in solid solutions, solvent is which one present in solid state. In liquid solutions, solvent present in liquid state. In gaseous solutions, solvent present in gaseous state. So now, again these are classified into another three types each one. That means here, solid solutions are again classified into three types. What are the three types here? First one is solid in solid type of solution. Second one, liquid in solid type of solution. Third one, gas in solid type of solution. That means here, solvent always present in solid state, but solute might be present in solid or liquid or gaseous state. Similarly, these are also classified into three types. What are the three types here? Same here also, always liquid present in, always solvent present in liquid state, but solute might be in solid, liquid or gas. So now the first one is here, solid in liquid. Second one is liquid in liquid. And third one is gas in liquid. Gas in liquid. Here also we get three types, but in this, always solvent present in gaseous state, but solute might be solid, liquid or gas. So the first type, solid in gas, liquid in gas, gas in gas. So, based on the physical state of both solute and solvent, total 9 type of solutions are present. But based on physical state of solvent only, three types of solutions are present. But based on physical states of both solute and solvent, 9 type of solutions are there. And we have to see examples also. Solid in solid type of solutions. What is the example for this means? Alloys. Alloys are examples for solid in solid type of solutions. So that means if you consider any ornament, any gold ring, but it is not containing only itself gold. It is mixed with some amount of copper. So like that here, alloys are examples of solid in solid type of solutions. Then come to the second one here, liquid in solid. Example, gels, like Colgate gel, etc. So, gels are example for which one? Liquid in solid. Then, gas in solid. For this example is here, occlusion of hydrogen gas on palladium. What is occlusion? Occlusion means adsorption of any gas on a solid surface is called occlusion. So, like that, adsorption of hydrogen gas on palladium surface. Come under this example, gas in solid type of example. And pumice stone, this present nearby seashore, that gas is adsorbed into that stone, pumice stone. Okay, now come to the second type here, solid in liquid. Solid in liquid means what? Sugar in water. Salt in water. So, sugar solution or salt solution. Next, come to liquid in liquid. Liquid in liquid means milk plus water. Milk plus water. This is an example for kids. But for the elders, another example is also there. Alcohol plus water. Alcohol plus water. Milk plus water. Come under liquid in liquid type of which one solutions. Okay, milk plus water. Next come to gas in liquid. Gas in liquid means example soda water. That means carbon dioxide gas is passed into the water. So gas in liquid example is soda water. And come to the solid in gas. Solid should be present in gas. Example, smoke. Smoke means carbon particles distributed in air. So, smoke is example for which one here? This solid in gas. Or camphor in air. Camphor in air. So, in the temples, that we can get that which one? We can observe that camphor. So, like that, camphor present in air is an example for solid in gas. Next come to liquid in gas. Liquid in gas means what is the example? Clouds. Clouds are the best examples of liquid in gas. Okay, then gas in gas means our atmospheric air. It has so many gases mixed with one another. So that is having a mixture of different gases. So these are the types of solutions based on physical state of solvent only and also based on physical state of solute and solvent. Okay, this is regarding which one? Classification of solutions based on physical state of solvent and also physical state of solvent and solution. Okay, our next video, next one is, okay, our next topic is, which one? That next topic is concentration of solutions. How to express the concentrations of solutions. So different methods are there to express the concentrations of solutions. What are the different types? Let us see here. So our next topic is here, concentration methods or methods of expressing concentration. So the first method is here. What is that? First one is here, mass percentage. First method is mass percentage. So what is the meaning of mass percentage here? The mass of solute in grams present in 100 ml of solution. Mass of solute in grams present in which one here? That 100 gram of solution, not 100 ml, sorry, 100 gram of solution, because it is mass percentage. So I will repeat again. The mass of solute in grams present in 100 gram of solution is known as mass percentage, or we can take the expression, which one, like mass of solute by mass of solution into 100, like that we can write the expression. So what is that expression? See here, mass percentage equals to mass of solute, of course this is in grams, mass of solute in grams divided by mass of solution into 100. This is one expression to calculate mass percentage, and this can be written in different ways. So mass of solution means it is the combination of mass of solute and mass of solvent. So we can rewrite like this here, mass percentage equals to mass of solute in grams divided by mass of solute plus mass of solvent. Mass of solute plus mass of solvent. And another expression also there here, mass percentage equals to mass of solute in grams divided by volume of solution into density of solution. Means what here? To get the mass of solution, another formula is what here? Volume of solution into that density of solution. And here, this mass of solute by mass of solution is known as mass fraction. So now, mass percentage equals to mass fraction into 100. So these are the different expressions to calculate which one? Mass percent or mass percentage. So one question I give here. For example, one question we get like this. 4% NaCl solution. 4% NaCl solution or 4% NaCl aqueous solution also they will give. Aqueous solution means what? Solvent is water. Solvent is nothing but water. So now what is this meaning? 4% aqueous NaCl solution means what? 4 gram of NaCl present in 100 gram of solution. 100 gram of solution. So now here NaCl is a solute, water is a solvent. From this how to get weight of solvent? Weight of solvent means weight of solution minus weight of solute. So now here, weight of solution 100 grams, weight of solute 4 grams. Therefore, weight of solvent is which one? Water. Weight of water equals to 100 minus 4 means what is the weight of water? Means 96 grams. So like that, we have to calculate which one here. Mass, that means weight of water or weight of solvent, weight of solute based on mass percent. Okay, then after this, another one, volume percent or percent by volume, or simply we can call it as volume percent. So what is the meaning of volume percent? So let us see here. Just now we got here mass percentage, means mass of solute present in 100 gram of solution. Like that here, volume percent means what here? The volume of solute. I will write here volume percent. Volume percent means, what is the definition? Volume of solute in milliliter present in 100 ml of solution. So volume of solute, volume of solute in milliliter divided by volume of solution, volume of solution into 100. So this is the formula to calculate volume percent or volume percentage. Okay, then if these two are given as a mixed one, that means what here? If mass of solute given in grams, solute amount is given in grams and solution amount is given in milliliters, then it should be called as which one? Percent mass by volume. Percent mass by volume means what here? Mass of solute that will be given in grams divided by volume of solution. This type of expression is called percent mass by volume. And next one is, what is that? Parts per million. This is also one important one here, one of the important methods to express the concentration. What is that? Parts per million, PPM. We can indicate like PPM. So what is the definition of parts per million? And especially it is expressed when the concentration is in trace amount. That means, for example, in our atmosphere, pollution is there. So many pollutants like CO2, SO2 causes pollution. So the concentration of that pollutants expressed in terms of PPM. So now here, PPM means full form is parts per million. So the number of parts of solute present in million parts of solution is known as which one? Parts per million. Number of parts of solute present in million parts of solution. Million parts means 10 power 6 parts of solution, known as which one? Means parts per million. So it's formula should be written as number of parts of solute, number of parts of solute by number of parts of solution, number of parts of solution into 10 power 6. So 10 power 6 is known as which one? Million. So like that, we have to calculate concentration in PPM using this expression. I give some questions related to PPM. See here. What is that question? First one. 1000 gram of solution, 1000 gram of solution containing, 1000 gram of solution containing 3 gram of which one? Any NaCl. So what is its concentration in parts per million? What is its concentration in parts per million? So now 3 gram of NaCl present in 1000 gram. 1000 gram means 10 power 3 gram. Therefore, how many gram of NaCl present in 10 power 6 gram of water? That means we have to write like this. 10 power 6 gram of solution. So 10 power 6 gram of solution contain how many gram of NaCl? So now that concentration in ppm equals to 10 power 6 by 10 power 3 into, that is 3. So we can get which one? 3 into 10 power 3 ppm. So like this, we should calculate which one here. Using this one, we have to calculate ppm. And sometimes they give in reverse way. What is that? They give concentration in ppm. We have to calculate the amount of solute present in some given amount. So like that, they can give the same question in reverse way also. So these are the different methods. Of course, some other methods also there. Molarity, normality, we will discuss in the next video. Okay, bye.